Friends, in our previous video, we have discussed about the plasma membrane, a part of protoplasm, a boundary delimiting the protoplasm. Now, let's enter into the cell, let's enter into the plasma membrane and discuss about the cell organelles. The cell organelles which are present in the eukaryotic cell, they are divided into two groups, and one of the groups is forming the endomembrane system. Endomembrane system. System inside the membrane. So, endomembrane system includes the cell organelles like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes and the vacuole. Vacuole, large conspicuous vacuole is present in the plant cell, and lysosomes are abundant in animal cells. Vice versa, lysosomes are less in plant cells or nearly absent, and vacuoles are nearly absent in the animal cells. So anyhow, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes, vacuole, these are the part of endomembrane system. Now why they are forming the endomembrane system? Why they are called as the part of endomembrane system? Because these are the cell organelles which are performing many functions in coordination with one another. They are coordinated with one another. There is a membrane flow among them. Membrane flow. We call it as GERL system. Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum, lysosome system. So, we see later on, we would elaborately discuss all these things. We see that endoplasmic reticulum cuts off some transportation vesicles which become the part of Golgi complex. Golgi complex cuts off vesicles which form the lysosomes. Lysosomes go to the plasma membrane, throw outside its material, and it becomes the membrane of the plasma membrane. So, it is incorporated into the cell membrane. In this way, or vice versa, in this way, all these four, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes and vacuole, they are the part of GERL system, or they are called as endomembrane system. They show some coordination in their work. Even lipid metabolism, it is conducted by endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi complex, phospholipids like that, protein secretion, etc. Many functions, all of them are doing together, working hand in hand, and therefore they are the part of. All of these are made up of single membrane. These cell organelles are made up of single membrane. There are some cell organelles which are made up of double membrane, like mitochondria, then the chloroplast, and these are mitochondria and chloroplast are not the part of endomembrane system. There might be one strong reason that once upon a time they were free living bacteria, because both of them, mitochondria and chloroplast, they are having their own DNA, extra chromosomal DNA, circular DNA. Therefore, in recent years, the science community, scientific community is concluding that these are endoparasitic bacteria. They are not true cell organelles because they are having their own DNA. So anyhow, these are very important, and they are controlling our life processes like photosynthesis and respiration. Leave it apart. These are not the part of endomembrane system. Now, these endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes and the vacuole, they are the part of endomembrane system. We would study them, we would discuss about them. Let's start with the endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum. Porter and Thompson, these are the two scientists. And they separately published the research work about the endoplasmic reticulum, and credit of discovery of endoplasmic reticulum is given to them. Porter and Thompson separately, not together, they were working in different labs. So they have published their work separately, and in this way, Porter also in 1945, Thompson also in 1945, published their work about discovery of the endoplasmic reticulum. Now, what is endoplasmic reticulum? Endoplasmic reticulum, the word means, endoplasmic means within, within cytoplasm. A reticulum means network. So they are forming, endoplasmic reticulum is forming an extensive network of three-dimensional interconnected membrane bound channels. What is it? Endoplasmic reticulum is forming a extensive network within the cytoplasm. What type of network? Network of, extensive network of interconnected three-dimensional membrane bound channels. And this, I have drawn a figure here, this endoplasmic reticulum, it at one end, or many a times, it is surrounding the nucleus, it is in continuation with the nucleus, and it may continue up to the plasma membrane or the cell membrane. Endoplasmic reticulum, extensive network, it is such huge network inside the cell, many a times it is counted that 50% of the plasma membrane or 50% of the biomembrane inside a cell is occupied by the endoplasmic reticulum. 50% plasma membrane is there, Golgi complex is there, other cell organelles, membrane bound cell organelles are there, all of them held together 50%, and only this endoplasmic reticulum consists of 50% of the biomembrane inside a cell. But it is not constant always, it differs according to the need. It is need based. Some secretory cells, it is more in quantity. Endoplasmic reticulum is absent in prokaryotes, it is absent in RBC, mature RBC, the red blood corpuscles of our body. It is absent there because only hemoglobin is present in the RBC. So endoplasmic reticulum is absent there. It is need based. In some cells it is extensive, in some cells its quantity is less. Now this endoplasmic reticulum, which is forming a three-dimensional, you can see here, three-dimensional. Generally we show it like this. These are the cisternae. But it is not like this. This is a three-dimensional structure. The cisternae are like this. They are folded. Endoplasmic reticulum is compartmentalizing the cell. It is huge network, and therefore it is giving a strength to the cell. It is present throughout the cytoplasm, and it is giving a rigidity to the cell also. The space inside the cell is divided into luminal and extraluminal due to this. Luminal space means the space which is present inside the endoplasmic reticulum. This is the endoplasmic reticulum. Inside it, it is consisting of a lot of space of the cell, and that space is known as luminal space, and the extra luminal space is the space outside the endoplasmic reticulum but inside the cytoplasm. The space of cytoplasm which is outside endoplasmic reticulum is extraluminal, and inside it, it is luminal space. Now this luminal space is in continuation with the nuclear envelope. You can see here the nuclear envelope having two nuclear membranes. In between the two nuclear membranes, some space is present, and that nuclear envelope space is in continuation with the endoplasmic reticulum. You can see here or here the space of the nuclear envelope. The space in between the two nuclear envelopes is in continuation with the space of this endoplasmic reticulum. Now this endoplasmic reticulum is present in three forms, roughly. These are the cisternae, then tubules, and the vesicles. Cisternae, tubules, and vesicles. Cisternae are the flattened structures. You can see here, these are the cisternae. They are three-dimensional flattened disc-like structures. Tubules are tube-like structures. We show it like this. These are the cisternae. Then here, tubes. These are the tubules and vesicles. These are the spherical structures which are cut off by the endoplasmic reticulum, vesicles. So these are the three forms of this endoplasmic reticulum: the cisternae, tubules, and vesicles. These are the cisternae, these are the tubules, and here you can see the vesicles. I have already shown them in the figure. Now this endoplasmic reticulum is of two types. The first one is rough endoplasmic reticulum, also called as granular, and the second one is agranular or smooth endoplasmic reticulum, also called as agranular. Now the difference is presence or absence of ribosomes. ATS ribosomes are present in the eukaryotic cell. So the surface, cytoplasmic surface, outer surface of the endoplasmic reticulum is occupied by the ribosomes, and in electron micrographs it appears to be granular structure. So granular rough endoplasmic reticulum is that endoplasmic reticulum in which the ribosomes are attached on its surface, cytoplasmic surface, outer surface. Remember, these ribosomes are also attached to the nuclear envelope. I have shown here, they are attached to the nuclear envelope, outer face or cytoplasmic face of the nuclear envelope. They are attached to the cytoplasmic face of the granular endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, ATS type ribosomes, because it is eukaryotic cell. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum is that endoplasmic reticulum in which there is no association of ribosomes. Ribosomes are absent. Now this again depends on the type of cell. The cells in which proteins are being synthesized, the rough ER is present in more quantity. The cells in which there is lipid metabolism or other substances are synthesized, there is less amount of ER, more amount of smooth ER. So depends which type of, both are interconnected. I have shown here, this is granular and this is agranular, smooth ER, both are interconnected. They are interconversible also. So in some cases or at some instances when protein synthesis needs to be triggered, to be speeded up, then granular ER increases. If there is no need of protein synthesis, smooth ER increases, granular ER decreases. All this is controlled by the endoplasmic reticulum itself. One more difference is there in rough endoplasmic reticulum, vesicles are more, cisternae are more, tubules are less. Cisternae and vesicles are present there. In smooth endoplasmic reticulum, tubules and vesicles are present, cisternae are less. they are known. Here also you can see tubular smooth endoplasmic reticulum is shown in tubular form. Mostly it is in tubular form. It cuts off vesicles. So vesicles are present in both the cases. So these are the two types of endoplasmic reticulum: granular and agranular, smooth and rough. Now come to the function, the most important thing of the endoplasmic reticulum. Now function also depends on the type. Let's discuss the function of a rough endoplasmic reticulum. The first one is, it is associated with protein synthesis. Now basically proteins are synthesized by ribosomes, not by this one. But the granular rough ER gives space or attachment sites for the ribosomes. So ribosomes are present on its surface, cytoplasmic surface. Naturally, the mRNA passes through these ribosomes and protein chains are formed, polypeptide chains are formed. Now these proteins, polypeptide chains, long elongated proteins, they enter at once when they are synthesized proteins, they enter into the lumen of this endoplasmic reticulum, and inside the endoplasmic reticulum they take the conformation, the shape. Initially the protein is a long chain and it folds and refolds, forming a particular, anyhow it forms a particular structure like this. So this is the actually conformation of a protein or structure of a protein after folding. Now this folding, this conformation of the shape of this protein takes place inside this endoplasmic reticulum, first thing. Second, endoplasmic reticulum of this type, rough endoplasmic reticulum, is present in abundant quantity in those cells in which there is protein secretion. The enzymatic proteins are secreted. So secretor cells basically have more amount of this type of ER. Now these cells are secretory proteins. Mostly they are secreted in the form of glycoproteins. Secretory proteins are mostly the glycoproteins. Glyco means this part is added in the protein, and it is oligosaccharide chain, carbohydrate part. Now when the protein enters inside the endoplasmic reticulum, it takes its shape, conformation is done, and then the oligosaccharide part or the carbohydrate part or the sugar part, it is attached to this protein. So the proteins become glycoproteins and they are ready for secretion now. So this is taking place. Now the, suppose pancreas secretes insulin. Insulin is a hormone which is directly poured into the blood, but this is protein based hormone. Some hormones are lipid based, some hormones are protein based. So this is, insulin is a protein based hormone. This insulin is secreted by the pancreas, and therefore the pancreatic cell have this much type of endoplasmic reticulum. A rough endoplasmic reticulum is more in pancreas because it is secreting cell, made up of secreting cells. So this is one function. Proteins are synthesized by ribosomes, but as soon as they enter into the endoplasmic reticulum, they take a particular shape, and for the glycoprotein preparation, the glyco part or oligosaccharide part is attached by certain enzymes which are present in the lumen of this endoplasmic reticulum. So many proteins, so many enzymes are present in it. Structural enzymes are present in the membrane of this endoplasmic reticulum, and some functional proteins are also present in the lumen. Now let's see second function. This is first function, protein synthesis. Though indirectly it is helping in protein secretion, storage of protein also. The proteins which are glycoproteins which are formed here, they are secreted in the form of vesicles. The translocation vesicles are cut off. These vesicles are cut off from this endoplasmic reticulum. Now second, one of the most important functions of the endoplasmic reticulum, it is called as the membrane factory. Endoplasmic reticulum, or especially this rough endoplasmic reticulum is called as membrane factory. The name itself is suggestive. It synthesizes membrane. The membrane which is needed, biomembrane which is needed by cell organelles, it is needed by Golgi complex, it is needed by plasma membrane or cell membrane. Even the nuclear envelope is also made up of the same membrane. So wherever the membrane is needed, it is supplied by this endoplasmic reticulum, a rough endoplasmic reticulum, because it has capacity to synthesize the membrane. Why? Because it has proteins. Ribosomes are associated with it. Ribosomes synthesize the proteins. Whichever proteins are needed for the membrane, structural and functional proteins, carrier proteins, integrated proteins, the extrinsic, intrinsic proteins. So those proteins are synthesized at this site. This also shows assembly of the phospholipids. Now, precursors of the phospholipids are present in the cytosol or cytoplasm of the cell. From that cytoplasm, the precursors of the phospholipids are picked up, brought inside the endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum, and phospholipids are assembled there. So, it is assembling phospholipids to form the bilayer, lipid bilayer. It is forming or synthesizing the proteins needed. Proteins, and it has already has oligosaccharides. So all the materials are present with it. Therefore, it has the enzymes in its lumen. With the help of those enzymes, it synthesizes membrane and it cuts off small vesicles, and these vesicles later on add into the Golgi complex, into the lysosome, into the plasma membrane or cell membrane, wherever it is needed. So this is the membrane factory, a rough endoplasmic reticulum. Now, along with rough endoplasmic reticulum, let's see what are the functions of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. It is also performing some very interesting functions. The first one is lipid metabolism, lipid synthesis. We will call it a synthesis. Protein synthesis is associated with this one, though it directly does not synthesize protein, but protein synthesis, protein secretion, protein storage is associated with a rough endoplasmic reticulum. In the same way, lipid synthesis, now whatever enzymes are needed for that, in association with the Golgi complex, of course, there is a certain part of Golgi complex in lipid synthesis. So, in association with Golgi complex, smooth endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes lipids. Now, some hormones which are lipid based hormones, like the testosterone, estrogen, these are the sex related hormones. These are secreted by the gonads. Gonads are present in the human body. So, in the vertebrata group, the male and female secrete these hormones, testes and ovaries. So, in the cells of testes, in the cells of ovaries, the smooth endoplasmic reticulum is abundant because it needs to secrete the testosterone, estrogen like hormones. So, all those hormones which are lipid based hormones, they are secreted by these and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Yes, ER. So, it is abundant in those cells. Detoxification of the drugs. This is also important function. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum is engaged in detoxification. Whatever enzymes are needed for that, it has those enzymes and it adds hydroxyl group in those drugs. For alcohol, suppose if we consume a lot of alcohol, the alcohol is removed by our liver cells, and for that it adds the smooth endoplasmic reticulum adds hydroxyl group to all toxic substances, all drugs which are toxic, and then it is hydrolyzed and it is washed away easily, solubilized by adding the hydroxyl group, and it is washed away. So the detoxification is done by smooth endoplasmic reticulum and the organs like liver, they have abundant SER to detoxify the materials. Whatever drugs we take inside our body, they are removed by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum by adding the hydroxyl group. So detoxification, certain enzymes which are needed for that, they are present with it, and it carries that function also, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Now along with that, smooth endoplasmic reticulum is also engaged in one of the most important activity, and that activity is maintenance of sugar level. Now this sugar, it is present stored in the form of glycogen in the liver. Liver stores extra amount of sugar and it releases needed amount of sugar in the blood, and anyway the it maintains the sugar level in the blood. That is very important. We know if more sugar in the blood, we have to face diabetes, or less sugar, that is also problematic. So the glycogen is stored, sugar is stored in the liver in the form of glycogen, and that glycogen, when it is solubilized and hydroxylized, and at that time glycogen forms glycogen phosphate, glucose phosphate first, and then the phosphate group is detached and this glucose is released in the blood. So when blood needs sugar, it is released in the form of glucose, and when the body needs to store the sugar, it is stored in liver by in the form of glycogen. Now this glucose phosphate cannot exit the liver cells. It cannot be thrown inside the blood. It needs to cut off. The phosphate group is needed to be cut off from the glucose, and this phosphate group is removed by certain enzymes which are present in the SER, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. It has that enzyme to cut this phosphate group, and this is maintenance of the carbohydrate regulation. This is called as carbohydrate or sugar regulation in the blood. This is done by smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So these are the main important or specific functions. The rough endoplasmic reticulum is engaged in protein synthesis, and it is storing the proteins, secreting the proteins. It is giving, adding some groups for to form the glycoproteins like that. It is the membrane factory. It continuously synthesizes membrane and gives it wherever needed. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum is important in lipid metabolism. It is detoxifying the drugs, poisonous substances from our body, and it is maintaining the carbohydrate metabolism, or it is maintaining the blood sugar level. Now these are specific functions. Along with that, the endoplasmic reticulum is abundant in the cell. It compartmentalizes cell, it increases the cell surface for certain things, just like the presence of protein synthesis. It is giving or providing surface to protein synthesis. The ribosomes are attached to it, and therefore it is giving or increasing the surface area for protein synthesis. Compartmentalization giving strength, because it is distributed throughout the cytoplasm, so it is giving strength to the cell. All these are the subsidiary functions. The important functions are these ones. So in this way, this endoplasmic reticulum is one of the most important cell organelle of our body.